Okay, good tubers, I'm back. After I have tested the engine on the water and still overheating, so I just took it apart for a second look, and this is what I have found. Okay, you can see I took the lower part off, and it was not that hard, so don't get scared. And this is the water tunnel right here that goes around the pistons on the head, and you see here, I don't know if you can see it with the GoPro, that goes on that hole here, and I'm gonna show you what I have found. Okay, right here, this is the screw, this is the bolt, and this is not a bolt, this is the water inlet. Okay, now I'm gonna show you what I have found on this one here. This goes here, okay, you see it, and that's the water tube that comes from the impeller right here, and believe it or not, it was clogged. So I have used blow some air inside, and it didn't come out on the other side, and actually I blow a couple more times and I got sand, as you can see now. It's nice. I leave that paper here so you can see the air blowing out from the tube. That never happened before. So I'm getting ready to put this back together. I have tested already the water pump. I'm gonna show you in a minute. And it's a little bit pain in the butt, but I'm not gonna quit on this engine yet, okay? I'm not gonna quit on it. It's a little bit pain in the butt, but I'm gonna fix it, I believe. So, let me put it back together and go for a sea trials again. And hopefully this time it's gonna cool properly, and it's not gonna ever overheat anymore. Okay, see you later. Okay, YouTubers, I'm back, and I'm gonna show you how to test your water pump, if it's working. I just put it back together after a little test, and I have found this video also on YouTube, and it's a good test before you put it all together. Okay, she's good. She's good. All right. Anyway, the second one didn't work out, but water comes up from the previous test because I don't want to damage the axle. The axle is kind of hard to turn right now. So gear is working, neutral. Okay, this is good. To start putting it back together. And it's beautiful here. It's like, we have like around 38, 39 degrees today. It's like 90, something, 95 like in the States. And the difference is, you see here it comes up. The tube is good. I put the flashlight inside, and it's always, always down connected. And you see the air comes out from there. So the only difference is like when I go back to New York, it's hot and humid. Here is dry. We are like north, like about 7-8 kilometers north of Athens. And it's beautiful, it's dry, dry weather, dry heat. So when you go out of the shade, you're cooling down. You're nice and cool. Okay. Maybe let's put it first on the engine. I took this part out so I can remove the axle easier, and I have marked it so I make sure it goes the right way in. Okay, let's clean this up a little bit. And I'm gonna check all these pathways before I connect these two together. You see, I have put a mark here. That's right here. Okay. And actually, this is the right way. All right, here is my mark, but you can see it. So this goes to the head. This is water. Now this is nice and clean. I have done it the last time, so you can see it. See that? Nice and clean. This is second. Now this is clogged. That was the second problem. Okay, so this has I have a sand inside. I blew it out. It almost cut my hand. That's how much sand was in there. Okay, so looks good. This is tension. This, the gasket is okay. So let's see. Let's see what's going on here. Okay, it looks like this I have to check, because it looks like this is the water return, maybe. So let's take a moment here. Okay, so this is, you see that? This is the water, this is this one, but there's another one here. And that's not it, this is it here. Something here, there you go. See it? See that? Let's find out. Let's see, this goes, yeah, this is the return. So let's see if this is clean. Okay, this is clean. Wow. Yep. And it just make sure. Supposed to be. This is the return. Well, helpfully the thing is clean, right? Because I'm not going to open the head again. I don't have another gasket right now, so... the wire goes all the way in. You know. Yeah, goes here. So helpfully this is, I don't have another gasket to open the head. So helpfully this is clean. If it's not, I have to get a gasket and open it again. Let's put it back together. Okay, so I put it back together. It took me like an hour. And I crank it. Get a lot of smoke, but that's probably where I put some little bit extra oil. You can see it here. And she started with the first crank. That's surprisingly. Thank God. Okay. So let's put it here, just before the recommended setting. Okay, check this off. Okay, and okay, so it works good. There's a little leak on the carburetor, but I know about that. Okay, and I have to put a little bit more water. You see it? It has to be over that, so I have to put more water a little bit, and I'll be back. Working like around, 5 minutes. A little bit hot. I can see the mist here. Pretty busy down there. Okay, I kind of like, I'm sure water comes up because I see it coming from the head, from right here. And so I tied the head bolts, figure eight, and there is no water coming out now. So I only hope the water returns, because when I crank it, I see sprinkles come from here. It comes like a spray or something, okay? And she needs to pull the choke a couple of times to start it when it's hot, but it starts fine. So helpfully this time is okay. The only thing I'm really worried about is the water circulates and returns, but the water definitely comes up to the head because I see it coming out from here. I tied the bolts and it's fine. And okay, let's take some temperature readings. It's Celsius, but okay, let's see here. I'm not sure. Let's see if I can put it here. It goes up to 80. When once it was working, it went almost to 180, and that's Celsius. I have to go online to find out what's the EGT. That's the the head temperature, the CHT, the cylinder head temperature for this engine. If anybody knows, please comment. Okay, and you can comment if you think I can do anything more on that. But basically that's about it for now. And you know, it's fun working on this engine, but I'm not doing it just for to have it, you know, on my small dinghy, on my small inflatable, but it's a lot of fun. Let me see here, it goes to like 75. Okay, up here it's like 45. I'm not sure here. What about here? This is getting also pretty hot. So I'm gonna do some reading, and hopefully this is good. Thanks for watching again. The reason I'm showing you this is because I never saw so much water coming out from here. Okay, so surprisingly, maybe something got cleaned up and plugged it or something. Let's do some readings again. Temperature. And let me see here. Okay. It goes like 80, 110, 115, 120, much better than before. It was almost 190. So maybe something got cleaned up there or something, you know. Okay. And here 45 on the top. It's very cool, 38. And she feels a little better. Maybe something got cleaned up and the water returning out. But well, this is the head, it's hot. But here I can touch it. I can touch it for 1, 2, 3 seconds maybe. I'm gonna do a couple more testing before I quit on this one. And looks encouraging. Let's see. And so I'll let you know next time. Thanks for watching.